Brett Hightower has walked the streets of Warren County for almost a year as its sheriff. It's the culmination of years in law enforcement in Southern Kentucky. But even that barely scratches the surface of his service to the community.
I feel advised that I'm 97 going 98 from the jailbreak from Andy.
As he goes about his days keeping his neighbors safe, he carries his battle scars.
My second daughter was a newborn. Literally, she was 3 weeks old when I left. I come home and you miss a year of their life.
Hightower is a veteran of both the Marine Corps and the Army National Guard. He served almost 22 years in the military, deployed 3 times, first in Operation Desert Storm, then Bosnia, and then Afghanistan.
And Afghanistan was just, there was so much going on in a very hostile area.
It was 2008. Hightower was 10 days from coming home.
I was in a firefight and got severely injured. I took basically a bullet fragment that went through my jaw and into my neck.
The hit fractured his jaw and severely damaged 2 major arteries. He was lucky he survived, but he had a long road ahead. The transition back to civilian life is difficult as it is, and now he was looking at 2 jaw reconstructive surgeries and weeks in a hospital bed.
I was really ready to get home and get on with life at that point, but they just kind of changed everything.
Still, Hightower is one of the lucky ones. He carries his experiences with him, but he's here. The same can't be said for all of his friends.
I was on a small 7-man team.
It was July 4th, 2008, Independence Day.
I was in a tent. He did it right outside the tent. And he did it in the night. I was sleeping, and then one of the guys heard the gunshot, he thought, and then went out there and we found him. You know, everybody handles stress differently. And he committed suicide. He was a great soldier.
Hightower's friend is not alone. Between 2008 and 2017, 2,850 active duty service members took their own lives. And during that same period of time, we lost 61,507 veterans to suicide.
Unless you've been there and see what goes on, people just don't realize the sacrifice that our soldiers and sailors and airmen are making on a day-to-day basis. I want to honor them by just helping others and being the best that you can be. I think we all have a lot still to give. Even if you come back and you're injured, and you've got to find your new mission and move forward.